Welcome to Reptile Ridge. While hiking through the swamp back in the spring, I came across this huge, long snake. It's pretty far out, and my view is obstructed by the leaves. At the moment, I'm unable to identify it. For a second, I think it might be a python. But pythons aren't native to South Alabama, not even to North America. So what? It wouldn't be the first time an alien species has been found where it shouldn't be. Just recently, on the local news, a man in the Florida Panhandle was arrested for owning an animal of concern. The animal was an alien species. A huge 10-foot-long albino python, weighing in at more than 100 pounds. Now, this snake is no python, but it is a close family relative. It's a gray rat snake. Like pythons, rat snakes are constrictors. They squeeze their prey to death. The reason Florida now bans keeping large, dangerous animals like pythons for pets. Pythons can grow large, and sometimes they become more than their owners can handle. The unfortunate animals are dumped in the local swamps and forests to fend for themselves. Sadly, many small children and pets have ended up victims of these aliens among us. The rat snake continues to search for prey, which could be hiding in the old hollow trees near the water's edge. That's probably one of the biggest ones I've ever seen. I'd say it's close to 7 feet long. The small offspring of this animal would be more suitable prey for the rat snake. But the adults are more suitable prey for pythons and anacondas in their native countries. Yes, this is another alien species. The nutria. Nutria are relatives of the beaver. They were introduced to North America back in the 1800s for the fur trade. Some of them managed to get here all on their own by stowing away on board cargo ships. In North America, they are considered an invasive species. They're on the hit list. Many are trapped, shot, and killed to be removed from the area. But the nutria are resilient creatures. They always manage to bounce back. They are peaceful plant eaters. I personally like them. And so do the alligators. As where I'd rather watch them forage for food, the alligators want them to become food. This large alligator is definitely on the prowl. The nutria in the area had better watch out. The alligators and turtles are native to our neck of the woods. The problem with alien animals is that they compete with the natives for food and habitat. For some native species, that can spell disaster. For instance, the introduction of the cane toad to Australia was a complete disaster. The frogs took over, nearly wiping out some species. That was a costly human error. Well, it's not alien aircraft. but it certainly seems out of place here. And so is Mocha, one of my pet lizards. He's a Guatemalan spiny-tailed iguana, definitely an alien species. He was captured against his will, put on a plane, and shipped into the world of the pet trade. Fortunately for Mocha, he's now living with us. He's quite handsome. I've had him for 3 months. I'm trying to provide him with the best habitat that I can. He's not hand tame, and he spooks very easily. He seems healthy. And there's a close look at his tail. You can see why they're called spiny-tailed iguanas. He eats mostly a diet of bananas and squash, sometimes the occasional strawberry. He can be rather finicky. Proper lighting for these animals is very important. This species of iguana has to have a light that they can get within 3 inches of in order to warm themselves and to help aid in food digestion. Yeah, he looks kind of funny hanging around up there. He does this at least once a day. And that's my baby, the princess, Opie the skink. She is a native species, known as the southeastern five-line skink. We have lots of different skinks native to North America. Her species is one of the most common. As you can see, she's fat and happy. She's been my pet for over 2 years. I found her when she was just a tiny hatchling. She's way too tame to release. So she'll live out the rest of her life with me. Hopefully that'll be a long time. They've been known to live in captivity up to 10 years. I haven't seen a whole lot of five-line skinks in the wild here on the ridge, so I thought I'd show you a little bit of footage of Opie. In the previous episode, we discovered the turtles and fish were not the only residents of the garden ponds. No, it's not an alien. But it is rather cute. It's a small bullfrog. And now, I'm about to kick off my first contest for the viewers. Name that frog. The rules are simple. All you need to do is think of a name to enter in the contest. I'll be posting a video response to this video explaining everything. Then you'll simply post a comment stating your name of choice in good taste. Then everyone will vote for their favorite. Good luck. And let's have fun naming that frog. See you next time.